Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you some festive holiday outfit ideas. I've actually split this up so there are 5 different occasions that I'm going to be showing you some options for, and I've done both a winter and a summer version for this outfit. If many of you are wondering, I actually live in Australia, which is in the southern hemisphere, but I know so many of you live in the northern hemisphere where it is currently heading into winter. The 5 different occasions that I'm going to be showing you outfits for include holiday shopping, as many of us are going out there and buying presents for our loved ones. The work holiday party, which I'm sure is going to look quite different for many of us this year, given that we have to socially distance. The same goes for the 3rd occasion, which is festive celebrations with friends, whether you're either going out somewhere if you can, or if you're having something in your own home. Outfit number 4 will be centered around what I would be wearing on Christmas morning. And then the final outfit will be centered around what to wear for Christmas lunch or Christmas dinner, depending on which one you celebrate. Today's video also includes a paid for integration with Linea, which I'm so excited to share with you, all centered around their jewelry collection. Now, I have been partnering with the brand for more than 5 years now, and I absolutely adore their minimalist aesthetic. The name Linea is the Norwegian word for lines, which is supposed to represent the minimalist aesthetic of the brand, which was founded back in 2014 by Roman and Jen, who were essentially fed up with having to spend so much money in order to get high quality leather goods. And they've since expanded into jewelry, which you may recall, I think it was last year, I partnered with them on their jewelry launch. I will link that video up here if you'd like to go and have a watch. Sustainability is at the core of their brand, which is one of the many things that I love about Linea. And you probably notice this with the bags that I have. They have just held up so incredibly well, and I continue to wear them year after year just because they are classic and timeless. They're not sort of trendy pieces. They're things that you will have for a very long time. And I think their jewelry collection also mirrors that same aesthetic and same mindset. They use recycled gold and recycled silver throughout the collection. Their jewelry pieces, which I will show you some close-ups of very soon, are made using 14 karat gold vermeil, which is 2.5 to 3 microns thick. And this is up to 5 times thicker than gold plating. This means that you can feel really confident that your jewelry pieces will not tarnish and that they are made to last, which I think is really important no matter what price point you are spending. And in addition to that, they also offset carbon emissions for every single purchase made through their web store. I will be styling up all of the outfits I feature in this video with the beautiful jewelry pieces from Linea, as well as incorporating a few of my favorite bags from the brand and my favorite petite watch, which I've been wearing for many years now. I will leave in the description box below a list of all of the pieces that I'm wearing so you can easily find them on their website. And I do actually have a personalized edit with all my favorite designs, so I'm gonna have that link down there as well. And I do have a discount code, which is Mademoiselle10, which will net you 10% off any jewelry purchases that you make. My personal favorite stack is definitely the Aurora ring, the Martine ring, and the Lilith ring, which I currently have on my right index finger. I just think it is so pretty and sparkly, very dainty, and it just really helps to jazz up an outfit. And for me, that's one thing I find jewelry does. It is the finishing touch, and it just really elevates your look, and you can really change the way it looks with the different jewelry pieces that you are wearing. So what I'm going to do now is just dive straight into the outfits.
The most important thing for me when I'm doing my Christmas holiday shopping is that I want to be comfortable, especially if I end up deciding to go and try something on for me. So for the summer outfit, I've gone for a basic t-shirt tucked into a gingham skirt, which I've belted at the waist. I really like the proportions here, and by belting a skirt that's a little bit too big, it has a paper bag effect. My shoes are super comfortable. They're just some simple ballerina flats, ones that I know I can have on my feet all day. My bag, I've gone for something crossbody because you want to have your hands free, especially if you're carrying around a lot of gifts. I highly recommend making sure you pack some little baggies as well so that you can pop your gifts in a reusable bag. And then I have a cardigan in case I get cold. For the winter edition of my holiday shopping outfit, I'm going to be wearing some super comfortable skinny jeans, a pair of boots that I know I can walk all day in, a really big oversized knit sweater, and a great coat that's going to keep me warm whenever I'm going outside. Again, I've got that crossbody bag because, as I mentioned before, you really do want to be hands-free when you are browsing the shops. I've also accessorized with my Linea jewelry. Depending on the restrictions where you live, these next 2 occasions may look very different for you, but I still wanted to cover them off anyway. For the first one, let's talk about the work holiday party. Generally, you'll be going straight from the office to the office party, so whatever you're wearing has to be something that's suitable to wear all day long. So for the summer edition, I've gone for a silk camisole. Now this is going to be workplace dependent, but I've always found that you can bare your shoulders at workplaces here, including corporate. But if not, you could easily go with a simple silk t-shirt. I've tucked that into some cream trousers, and then because I wanted to really play on the earthy tones, I've gone for some terracotta sandals, which I think works really nicely with the camisole. In case it gets a little bit cold, I've grabbed a cardigan just so I can throw it over my shoulders, and I've kind of continued the neutral theme there. You'll be able to see my Wellington roots coming through here, but for the work holiday party in a winter setting, I would go for an all black outfit playing on texture. So this skirt that I'm wearing, it has all of these sort of ruffled layers which creates movement, and then it has a flocked detailing on the fabric which is almost like a velvet effect, which I really love. There's a bit of mixed textures here because I have gone monochrome, so that's a way to really help elevate your outfit. So I've got the micro rib with the turtleneck, and then I also have on those suede pumps. I've accessorized with my Chanel Classic flap, which also adds the leather element. One thing I know I'll be doing over the festive season is celebrating with friends. So for summer, I would go for a really nice light floaty dress, something that is sleeveless and that I can just accessorize with a fabulous pair of heels. I've gone for my leopard print pumps here because I think they are such a statement maker, and honestly, I don't really get many occasions to wear shoes like this, so it's always a little bit of fun when I can pull them out. When you've got a really simple outfit like this, it is a time where you can really amp up the jewelry aspect and go bold. For the winter edition of Celebrating with Friends, I've gone for my long sleeve marl ribbed dress. I just think that this is so elegant, and it's the kind of thing that I know I want to be able to wear in a more dressed up setting. I just think it works so well. I've thrown a leather jacket over the top. By adding a leather jacket, I've kind of created the slightly edgy appeal to the outfit. And then I've gone really kind of fun and festive and just really over the top embellished with the shoes. Okay, so it is finally Christmas morning, the day we have all been waiting for, where we get to spend some time with our loved ones. I don't know about you, but I'm generally spending this time in my PJs. For the summertime, I'm going to be wearing something that is short sleeved, or maybe even a camisole, maybe something that is a little nighty. But just something cute, and maybe I will have treated myself to a new pair of PJs to sleep in the night before. I always feel like that makes it a little bit more special. One thing I feel like I'm missing for the winter time is a nice big fluffy robe. But underneath, what I'd be wearing is some pretty silk PJs. As I mentioned earlier, I do feel like Christmas time is a great excuse to wear a more special pair of pajamas, given that it is an event that only comes around once a year. And then to keep my feet nice and toasty, I'll be wearing a really chunky pair of socks. These ones are a ribbed wool cashmere version. Our family celebrates Christmas with a massive lunch that goes on for hours, and usually by the end of it, we are completely stuffed. So I always want to wear something that is very comfortable and that I know I'm not going to be sitting there feeling like a stuffed sausage in. For summertime, I'm probably going to be wearing a really nice floaty dress. This one from Matteau with the floral print on it is a recent purchase, and I really, really adore it. I feel like it's kind of the perfect Christmas lunch outfit. It feels special, it's elevated, but then it's also really easy to wear. I've just worn it with some simple sandals and then a little straw bag, and then I've accessorized it with those pretty jewels from Linya. For my final outfit and the winter Christmas lunch look, I've gone for some leather trousers. I find that this particular pair has a little bit of give, so I know that they're comfortable enough to be able to wear during a big lunch, although a really nice pair of elevated sweatpants is also a great option. Then a really lovely, luxurious, cozy knit. This one has a V-neck and you can wear it tucked in or you can just wear it loose. I love it. I love the warm color. And then on my feet, I've just gone for some loafers. And again, I finished off my look with some pretty jewels. I love, love, love this pendant from Linya. And I think it pairs really perfectly with the sweater because the V-neck draws your eye downwards, so you're staring straight at the pendant. So those were the 5 different occasions and the 10 different outfits. I hope that you enjoyed this video and that you got some ideas for the upcoming festive season. I always love this time of year, although I know that 2020 is going to be very different for all
all of us. So I hope that you are staying safe and looking after yourself. That is the number one most important thing. As I mentioned at the start of this video, if you would like to go and check out the beautiful Linea jewelry pieces that I've been wearing throughout, then please make sure to click on the link down in the description box below. And do remember that if you want to make any purchases, that you can get 10% off your jewelry items using the code Mademoiselle10. Thank you again for watching this video and spending a little bit of your day with me, and I will see you next time with a brand new one. See you soon. Bye.